Hi everybody, good evening. Hello, hello, how are you doing?
Good evening,
teacher.
So, good evening everybody, how are you? How are you doing today? ¿Cómo estuvo su fin de semana? How was it?
Very
good, teacher, and you?
Evening, teacher.
I think it was okay, I think it was good. Nice in general, you know, I rested a lot, especially for la lluvia, you know, so I think it was good. What about your weekends? Did you have a good
hello,
weekend?
Hello, good evening.
Hello, good evening, how are you?
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening, guys. Hello, hello. No, 1 second here. Alrighty, so thanks a lot for joining. Gracias por estar acá. Me alegra verlos, you know, una semana más, okay? Terminamos nuestro módulo el día lunes, así que pretty much esta es la semana completa que vamos a tener. I'm super excited porque el mes ha pasado super. El módulo ha pasado muy rápido and pretty much ya estamos, you know, going over el último pedacito, you know, de los temas. Today terminamos nuestra unidad número 3, so vamos a hacer un general review sobre Simple Past. Vamos a revisar también cómo dar recomendaciones, how to give recommendations, and some vocabulary que todavía tenemos pendiente. Así que, guys, espero que hayan tenido un fin de semana de descanso, que la hayan pasado súper bien, que hayan disfrutado de las lluvias, and well, let's get started. Nuestra, digamos, última semana completa, because pretty much terminamos el día lunes. So, si me ayudan con la camarita un par de minutitos, solo let me go over the attendance. Voy a revisar asistencia. So, additionally, quiero también agradecerles a quienes ya me terminaron la plataforma. I have been checking y muchos ya me terminaron la semana número 4. Thanks a lot for that, you know, es bastante satisfactorio ver que han avanzado bastante. También ya empecé a recibir los audios, algunos ya me lo enviaron, otros estamos pendientes por ahí, así que tenemos, you know, up to today para poder enviar nuestros audios y practicar un poquito de pronunciation, fluency, that is very important as well. Para la siguiente, at the end of the module, les voy a indicar cuál es la actividad que tenemos para estas semanas para que también la empiecen a preparar, right? So, let me get started with attendance. My first person is Ana Delmi. Ana está por acá. Ana. Can you see her? Brenda, si está por ahí, I guess.
Present.
Hello,
teacher.
Brenda. Thanks a lot. Brian. Not yet. Jasmine está con nosotros. Are you with us? Yes, not yet. Danny's already. Daisy Lorena. Hey, hello, Daisy. How are you?
Hello.
Glad to see you. Me alegra verla, miss. I'm super glad to see you here. Giovanni, hello, Giovanni. Also, you're back. Hi there. How are you? ¿A dónde me dejó Danny? Where did you leave him? All right. Hey, Giovanni, but I'm super glad to see you. Danny, hello, Danny.
Hi, teacher.
There you are. Nice to see you, Danny. My next person is Natalie. Hi, Natalie. I'm glad to see you. Glad you're here with us. We have also Ingrid. Ingrid, me imagino que va camino a su casa. Guess you're on the way home. Thank you so much. Jacqueline.
Present teacher.
Thank you, Miss. Jocelyn. Ahí está Jocelyn, there you are.
Present.
Amazing, thank you very much. Norberto, hey Norbert.
La cinta del cardillo.
Thank you, Norberto. Thanks a lot. So my next person is Miriam. Hello, Miriam. Por ahí creo que la vi hace unos minutitos.
Hello, hello.
Hello, good evening. Thanks for joining me. Moses. Hi, hello. Moses.
Hello.
Glad you're here. Pedrina. Hi, Pedrina. How are you?
Present, teacher.
Great. Thank you very much. Renee. Renee's not here, I think. Ricardo. Hi, Ricardo. I think I saw Ricardo also. Creo que vi a Ricardo, pero algo pasó, I think.
Present.
Oh, there you go. Thank you.
¿Se escucha bien, teacher?
Yes, yes, I can hear you.
Okay.
Sandra Abigail. Sandra Rodas.
Present teacher.
Hello, Miss. I'm glad you're here. How are you? Hope everything is good, Sandra. Thank you, Dennis. Hello. Sandra Flores.
Present teacher.
Thank you. Thank you, Sandra. Ana Yancy, por ahí vi que se conectó también.
Present teacher.
Gracias, Miss. Thank you very much. Ángel. Ángel, are you around? No. Carlos Alberto. Guadalupe. Hey, Guadalupe. Good evening. Hello,
good evening,
Miss.
Teacher.
Glad you're here. Ignacio. And Marvin. They're not here. Okay. Okie dokie. Okay, I think that's it, right? Yeah, I don't think I'm missing anybody. All right, alrighty. So, gracias a todos por unirse. Thanks a lot for sharing, you know, esta semana con nosotros y por la motivación de continuar, you know, por estar súper atentos acá and ready to continue checking and learning and practicing. That's very important as well. So, el día de ahora vamos a hacer un breve repaso de temas gramaticales y, por supuesto, speaking. So, vamos a revisar like some important vocabulary and some things que teníamos pendientes as well. Check the chat. Okay. Okay. Gracias, Ingrid. Gracias, Danis. Glad you're here. So, let's get started today. Previous week, estábamos revisando un poquito de recomendaciones. So, we were checking some recommendations with should and shouldn't. Estuvimos viendo también un poquito de could para posibilidades, right? And to request para pedir cosas. Revisamos también would you mind para hacerlo de forma muchísimo más cortés, all right? So, today, okay, vamos a revisar un par de temas like this, and I have to get started. Tengo un par de preguntitas que vamos a practicar before anything else. So give me one second here. Let me just share this with you. Give me just a second. Hold on, hold on. Allow me just a second. Let me share my screen here. Hold on. Permítanme hacer el cambio nada más de administrador. I think that's it. All right, so let me present. I still present my screen. Okay, so let's take a look at this part. So, comencemos hablando un poquito like these three questions I have for you. And I really am interested, okay, to hear about your last weekend. So here we have, let's talk. And we have these three questions. Question one says, what did you do last weekend? Okay, last Saturday, last Sunday. I know that it started raining. Okay, so the weather is changing. The season is changing. I don't know in your houses, but in my house, it rained on Sunday and it rained today. So it has been like raining a lot. We have also this question, where did you go, right? And we have also the other one that says, what did you do today? So let's talk a little bit about your weekend, guys. Okay, vamos a hablar un poquito de nuestro weekend. No quiero que lo escriban. I don't want you to write it down, but I want you to speak about it, okay? To give as many details as you can. So el día de ahora vamos a practicar eso. We are going to practice details. Dar tanta información como podamos, you know. Since the questions are in past, vamos a hacer el cambio pasado, todos los verbos en pasado. If you don't know how to say it, you can use your dictionary. Pueden usar la lista de verbos para cambiar sus verbos a pasado. All right? So let's discuss these three questions. Question one, what did you do last weekend? Question two, where did you go on the weekend, right? And what did you do today? So if you are ready for this, let's get started. Give me just 1 second. We are going to discuss the questions in groups. And then we come and we answer them and we share opinions. So, hablemos tanto como podamos. Use English, okay, to communicate your ideas. No importa si las dicen bien. Si hay algún error gramatical, try, intenten decirlo todo en inglés, ¿ok? So, everybody, let's get ready. Tenemos solo 5 minutitos. You got only 5 minutes to answer these questions.
que no. Me sale.
Hello, hi guys. Deme un segundo. Porque me aparece ya que acá. Hold on. Hold on. ¿De qué pasó? I don't know what happened. Okay. Qué raro está la vista. Give me one second. Oh, ahí está. Okay. There it. That's it.
Good evening, teacher.
Hey, Brian. How are you?
Hi. I'm fine.
Glad you're here. I hope you had a nice weekend. So let me see. Ana Delmi, hello Delmi. See you here.
Hello, teacher.
Brian's hi, teacher.
Here. Hi, Moses. Hi, Marvin.
Hi, Marvin.
Hi, teacher.
Hey, boys.
Hi, Anis. Brenda. Danis. Danny Dolls.
Hi.
Danny, aprovecho, señor. Aprovecho,
señor.
Thank you.
La dieta, la dieta.
La dieta.
Remember.
I eat salad.
Oh, you're having salad.
Yes.
I don't believe you. I don't like salad.
Yeah.
Little Coca-Cola.
I like chicken with soda.
Es Coca-Cola específicamente.
EFD
Coca-Cola.
Oh, by the way, I remember you had to give us some recommendations to stop drinking Coca-Cola. So from last classes, I remember somebody mentioned they had a specific recommendations for that. So that would be nice if you can share that. Yeah, to stop drinking Coca-Cola.
Drinking more water.
Yeah, but it's hard. Okay. Okay, everybody. So that was a very nice practice, the one we have. Estuve escuchando and I'm super happy with improvement. Yo sé que al inicio cuesta un poquito los verbos, you know. Y es importante que nos tomemos el tiempo de memorizarnos al menos 30 verbos para iniciar, you know. Los más comunes, no les pido verbos como encoger, por ejemplo, o verbos como, like, super raros que nunca los vamos a utilizar probablemente. But I'm asking you to memorize los verbos que usamos todos los días. Por ejemplo, ver, you know, comer, ir, beber, manejar, trabajar. So, verbos y cosas que nos pueden utilizar in everyday life to
dormir.
Communicate better, dormir, exactly. Son cosas que decimos, que lo hacemos todos los días, you know, son nuestra rutina. So, well, la tarea anterior, de hecho, era bastante similar. Habían verbos en pasado. For this one, les voy a indicar cuáles son los verbos que nos vamos a memorizar y el audio que van a mandar, of course, right? So, ya les voy a publicar también para que nos vayamos memorizando poco a poco esos verbos. No worries. So, what about question number one? What did you do last weekend? ¿Alguien nos quiere compartir? Does anybody want to participate? One activity is okay, no nos tienen que contar every single activity, but one or two things, that's perfect. Dennis? What did you do last weekend, Dennis?
I was working in my house.
Okay. On Saturday?
Sunday and Saturday.
Okay. Already, thank you. Anybody else? Ingrid, what did you do last weekend?
Worked. Okay, and visit my sister.
My mother.
Siempre. Oh, no sé cómo se dice siempre aquí en la colonia. Visit my mother.
You visit your mom in the same neighborhood. Okay, in the same neighborhood.
Same. Okay.
Already. Guadalupe, what did you do?
I was rest in my house, teacher.
You rested. Wow, nice. I envy you. Okay, you rested a lot. Nice. Moses, what did you do?
I was at my house on Saturday.
Oh.
And on Sunday, it was a friend beer day.
Oh, did you go? Did you go to the party?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Pero es un party de niños.
Okay. It was not an adult party.
Okay.
Oh, with piñata and everything. Did you collect candies? Did you pick up some candy?
Yes, yes.
Ah, okay, okay. Yeah, I like parties because of the piñata.
So,
Yeah, okay. No, no beers. Okay. Uh-huh.
No, no beers. No.
It's a healthy party. That's a healthy one.
No
okay.
beers.
So, Jency, what about you? Where did you go last weekend? Where did you go, Jency?
I was floated with water in the beach, in El Tunco Beach.
You were at El Tunco? Ooh. Okay, that's wonderful. Do you live super close to El Tunco? Do you live close? Do you live close to El Tunco? Or do you live in El Tunco?
Yes. In El Tunco.
You live in El Tunco?
Live in El Tunco.
Nice. Super, super cool.
Yes.
Already. What about today, guys?
I have one store.
You got a store, okay? And you live there. But that's amazing. Already. What about the last? What did you, what did you do today? So talking about general activities, what did you do today, Giovanni? Giovanni. Already, Giovanni me dejó en visto. Okay. Jocelyn, what did you do today?
I worked as teacher.
You worked, okay. So you worked in the, like all day long. What time did you finish working?
At 5 p.m.
Okay, okay. Yeah, like pretty much a full-time job, okay? Okay, guys, now let's continue. That was pretty much just the intro. So vamos a revisar one topic here super fast para que podamos hacer un review de Should, okay? In the last week, estábamos hablando un poquito de recommendations, if you remember. And part of recommendations, we were working with this word that is should and shouldn't, right? Donde le decimos qué es lo que deberían o no deberían de hacer. So one more time, this part of recommendations no es una obligación, no es que tienen que hacerlo, but it's just what I think for you, lo que yo considero que es adecuado, right? So you should and you shouldn't. And if you remember, something important is the following. Cuando utilizamos should and shouldn't, no vamos a tener ningún cambio con el verbo, right? No le agregamos ese, no le agregamos pasado. No importa si es tercera persona or anything, no se cambia el verbo y tampoco se le agrega to. No utilizamos you shouldn't or you should to, right? So taking this into consideration, revisamos un poquito the following exercises and help me complete them. So here we have the following. Hold on. I'm gonna share this out. Okay, here it is. So we have a couple of exercises and it says read the sentences and write should or shouldn't. Solamente vamos a escoger what is the correct form. Okay. Ya tenemos el verbo, no lo vamos a hacer ningún cambio. Only you have to decide if it is should or shouldn't. Algo que deberíamos o no deberíamos hacer. So number one, for example, it says, if it's rainy, como ahorita, right? Si está lluvioso, if it's rainy, you should or you shouldn't take an umbrella. What do you think?
You should,
teacher.
Exactly, you should take an umbrella. What about two? Tom, and we have eat so many lollipops, okay? A lollipop is como un bombón, all right? Una paleta, un bombón. So Tom?
Should not.
Shouldn't.
Exactly. Shouldn't. So Tom should not or Tom shouldn't eat so many lollipops because it's bad for his teeth, all right? Number three. What about number three? Number three is a question. What do you think is the best way? Should or shouldn't? Should I drink or shouldn't I drink?
What is throat? Throat.
Sore throat. It says hot tea if I have a sore throat. Dolor de garganta, right?
Yes, yes.
Yes. Is it check? Esa es una pregunta. Yo quiero preguntar si es debería yo tomar algo, you know, para el dolor de garganta. So yes, here it is. Should I drink hot tea? Should I drink hot tea? If I have a sore throat? And the answer is yes.
Yes, you should.
Exactly. Yes, you should, right? It's a good idea. What about number four? Number four says they have a test tomorrow. Go to the cinema.
They shouldn't.
They shouldn't. Oh, they shouldn't go to the cinema.
They shouldn't.
Okay, they shouldn't go to the cinema. And olvidé el espacio acá, pero digamos que hay un espacio, okay? So they should stay home and study. Exactly. What about number five? Who wants to help me with number five? Children.
Should eat lots of sweets, but not candies.
Okay. No candies, exactly. Sweets son los dulces, yes. Number six, I have a party tonight. What? Again, es una pregunta. What?
Should I wear?
Exactly. What should I wear? ¿Qué me pongo? ¿Qué debería usar? ¿Qué debería vestir? Right? What should I wear? A dress or a pair of trousers? What do you think? If it's a party?
A dress?
Maybe a dress.
A dress,
right?
Teacher.
Maybe a dress sounds better. Okay.
A dress.
Yeah. Number seven, the doctor said you
should eat
healthy food and fast food. What about fast food?
You shouldn't eat fast food.
Very good. Yeah, and the last one, yeah, no comida rápida, right? You shouldn't eat fast food. And the last one, that is number eight, you shouldn't watch so much TV. Exactly, it's a bad idea. So you shouldn't watch so much TV. Perfect, very good. So if you pay attention, should es super fácil de usar. Solo es como, tú deberías hacer esto. You should do this, or the opposite, you shouldn't do that. I have a couple of suggestions for the following exercise, that is number five, and it says write suggestions about the following behavior. Number one says Sarah never stops chatting on the phone when we have lunch. Number two says my boss doesn't like to walk to my desk when he needs something. He shouts, okay? So me grita, he's like, Natalie, come here, you know, so he shouts at me, all right? Jimena and Susan take many selfies when they are working. Guys, se toman selfies. Do you take a lot of selfies when you're working?
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Okay.
I don't know.
You don't like it? Okay. But it says here too many, demasiadas. Okay. So too many selfies when they are working. So what do you think about it? Is there any recommendation from your side to them? Then we have Pablo posts the sign not a good time in his office door. So his team doesn't talk to him, but this is an office. So imagine that, for example, imagine that Sandra is the manager. El manager no quiere hablar con nadie, you know, and Sandra posts a sign that says not a good time, but she's the manager. What do you think? Is that a good idea? Or I don't know, should she express this in a different way? So what's your recommendation? And the last one says, Graciela always signs her emails with the emoji. And look at this. This is like a blinking emoji, right? Como el de un ojito abierto, un ojito cerrado. So it's like a blinking emoji. Okay, so, and if it's a professional email, what do you think about it? Is that a good idea? ¿Alguna vez no. envían? Do you use this emoji?
No, no, teacher.
No?
No.
Well, I like other type of emojis, pero personally, este no sé qué significa. I don't know what it means. I just know that it's a blinking emoji. So you can give us some recommendations. ¿Por qué no debería de usarlo? O si debería de seguirlo usando, right? So, I want you to come out. Quiero que solamente se pongan de acuerdo, okay? And make suggestions about these behaviors. Que den un par de sugerencias about this. What should they do? Vamos a hacerlo in like a group activity para que se puedan ayudar. So you can help each other, okay? And everybody can participate. Así que please help each other. Ayúdense. So listen to your classmates, and if you don't agree, pónganse de acuerdo. Find like some recommendations together. We have a couple of minutes. Tenemos 5 o 7 minutitos. So please go there, and I'll see you in 5. Está en su material. This is in the last page of unit number 3. So pueden utilizar el material o le toman captura acá. You can take a picture here.
Hello, Miss.
Teacher, me sacó del grupo, teacher.
Hi guys, thanks so much for coming back. So,
teacher,
hi Anthony.
Me sacó del grupo, teacher, y ya no le escribí que me que ya no me puede meter.
Really, I'm sorry, no he revisado el teléfono, I haven't checked. But thank you. Oh, sí, acabo de ver. All right, but thank you. But creo que había practicado, right? So you practiced a little bit with these guys.
Yes, yes.
Había practicado como un poquitillo. Okay, okay. So that's already. Okay, everybody. So listen up. Oh, where is everybody? They are coming in 30. So estamos dando like some recommendations. They sound very interesting. And I'm looking forward to listening to your experiences and your recommendations because I heard y algunas son bien extremas, let's say. Like, for example, okay, cambias de empleo. Look for a different job. That's not for you, you know. So I definitely would like to listen to your recommendations with this. So let's take a look at what we have. Revisemos qué es lo que tenemos and the most interesting situations here. For example, number three, that I think is very interesting. Jimena and Susan take many selfies when they are working. ¿Qué les recomendarían? What would you recommend? What's your idea in here?
They show them. Take selfies are working.
Okay, they shouldn't take selfies already. Anybody else?
They shouldn't use telephone in the work.
Okay, they shouldn't use the telephone. Norberto?
The company should make some rules the use of the phone.
Oh, the company, okay, should make some rules. All right. Anybody else? Any other recommendation?
Jimena and Susan should selfies when it's vacation.
Okay, they should say only selfies when it's vacation time. Already, I think it sounds good. It sounds okay. What about number four? ¿Alguien tiene alguna recomendación de la cuatro? Like Pablo posts the sign not a good time in his office door and the team doesn't talk to him. So what do you think about this? What do you think about number four? Is there any recommendation que quieran darnos con la número cuatro? Like we really shouldn't talk to him? Realmente no deberíamos hablar con él? Or what do you think?
Go to the therapist.
Okay, so go to a psychologist, go to therapy.
I don't, I never talk with him.
Okay, okay, so not a good time, you wouldn't talk to him and he should go to a psychologist. All right, thank you. That's a good one. Anybody else? Do you have another recommendation? I think he shouldn't do it. So no debería de hacerlo. He shouldn't do it. You know, he should, I don't know. Pedir permiso maybe? She asked for a leave and not go to work, but he shouldn't post it. What do you think?
Ex-boss? Yeah, I'm sorry.
No, 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 it's okay. Go ahead.
He was... he said, don't, algo parecido, not a good time, but he said at the secretary, for she say to us, don't go to where the bus, but okay. I get in the office, the bus, because I don't do him nothing but. Okay. I go in the office. He must listen to me.
Oh, okay.
That I have to say is important.
Oh, okay. So in your case, probably it should be like a good way to ignore like the message or to ignore the site that he has. Okay, and go and talk to him already. That's okay. Anybody else? Do you have a different opinion about this? Any other recommendation? No more of this? Okay, not a problem. That's totally fine. Now, I have just one more, and I need your help with this, okay? Vamos a dar recomendaciones con esta, but vamos a hacerle una conversación. We are going to make it into a conversation. If you take a look, we have some more situations, okay, that are like everyday life, okay? Imagine that you are talking to a friend, y un amigo me cuenta eso. So one of my friends is having this problem, and I have to go come and give recommendations to my friend. For example, I have number one that says, I have just lost my job. Okay, so the person was fired. I haven't told my wife or my husband yet. How should I tell him or how should I tell her? Okay, so, se acabó de perder mi empleo. I have just lost my job. Y mi esposa o mi esposo no lo sabe. Okay, no le he contado. How should I tell her? ¿Cómo le digo? ¿O cómo le digo a un miembro de mi familia que perdí el empleo? Should I tell my family? ¿Debería de esconderlo? Should I hide it? ¿Debería de mentir? Should I lie? What do you think? Should I talk to my family and tell them what's going on?
Should tell. Debería decirle.
I should tell them? Okay. Probably should tell them.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes. No hiding.
Okay, I shouldn't hide it. Okay. Yeah. Or for example, number three. I found a wallet with $2,000 in it. How should I spend it? Well, primero, ya dice que cómo se lo va a gastar. But it's like, I found a wallet with $2,000. Guys, ¿qué harían? ¿Cuál es su recomendación? If you found a wallet with $2,000. Primero, ¿qué debo de hacer? What should I do?
Found a wallet es como...
Encontré una... Yeah, oh, I found. El pasado de find. Yo encontré una billetera.
Sí.
I found a wallet with $2,000. ¿Qué debería de hacer? What should I do?
Let's go.
No. Okay, go away.
Go ahead.
Call the
proprietary.
¿Qué harían? What should I do? Take it? Lo tomo? Do I take it?
No.
Bye. I give the proprietary.
Si no lo agarro, okay. A otro.
Mm-hmm. What? I give it to the owner? Se lo doy al dueño?
I shall find information.
I should look for information. Debería de buscar. Okay.
Review ID.
Okay. Pero si no hay ningún ID, there is no ID, no address, no phone number.
De repente aparece un ID.
So you take. Okay, you take it. Okay, you should take it.
It's complicated.
Maybe
I
show to speak to Gondo City. To post in Facebook.
Oh, okay. You should go to the social network, okay? To Soya City and post it, okay?
Si no hay nada.
I buy new car.
No, with $2,000. Okay, so this is like a little hard, you know, but it's your recommendation. So ¿qué deberíamos hacer, right? Yeah, it's complicated, definitely. Yeah. We have this other situation, number four. It says, my child wakes up. Yeah, so para los que tienen bebés, children.
Yes.
My child wakes up very often in the middle of the night. He sleeps usually during the day. I haven't had any good sleep for weeks. Yeah, como cuando sus hijos se levantan a medianoche y no los dejan dormir. So I haven't had any good sleep. So Spanish.
Se les cura
pau.
Spanish them, okay.
Okay.
Any recommendation for the ones who have children? ¿Qué hacen? Oh, para los que tienen babies?
Talk with children.
Okay, yeah. Talk to them.
Yeah.
Okay.
In the day, the God
the out of the house. Mm-hmm. And the teach enseñarle que está de día, ¿no?
Yes.
Teach them. Okay. And y this moment is the
night.
Wake up.
Yeah.
Eh? Okay. So they shouldn't sleep during the day.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. They shouldn't sleep during the day. Or as you said, you should punish them. Okay, no, debería castigar. You should punish them. Yes. No, I mean it's your recommendation, right? Todos tienen un método diferente and that work or that can work. So we are going to listen to you in a couple of minutes. Number 5 says, I have a headache. What should I do? Si tengo dolor de cabeza, if I have a headache, ¿qué debería de hacer? What should I do?
I drink a beer.
For a headache.
I drink
a beer. I drink acetaminophen.
No.
Acetaminophen, paracetamol.
Acetaminophen.
It's bad.
Go to the doctor. What is the other one? Tylenol.
Drink Coca-Cola.
Oh. You should drink
coffee.
Coca-Cola, coffee?
Lie, please.
I don't know, but people say that Coca-Cola is good or coffee is good for la cafeína, but I don't know. So maybe you have a better experience than me. And the last one is very interesting and crazy, I have to say. It says, I hate working. No me gusta trabajar. I hate working. What should I do? So what is like your recommendation if I don't like working?
Okay.
Ah, to be a YouTuber. Okay, make a job in YouTube.
¿Cómo se dice cambiar, teacher?
Change.
I should change work. No.
Okay, yes. I should change my job, pero tal vez algo que sea, no sé, más diverso, you know.
Sugar mom.
Yeah. Or sugar daddy.
Yes, sugar mom.
That's crazy.
I love you.
Ay, Ricardo, es terrible. Okay, so what we gotta do is the following. What I want you to do, guys, is van a escoger una situación. You're going to choose only one of these situations, cualquiera de las que, you know, you wanna share, y van a crear una conversación. So one of you les explica cuál es el problema, what's the problem, and the other person is going to give recommendations. For example, imagine that my partner is Daisy, and I can tell her like, Lorena, you know, I have a terrible headache. I didn't eat today, and yesterday I didn't sleep well. So no dormí bien, I didn't sleep well. What should I do? Okay, ¿qué debería de hacer? What should I do, Lorena? What do you recommend me? Okay, and she can start, I know. So you should eat every single day. You should sleep for 7 hours. And you know, y es como una conversación donde le explicamos qué nos está pasando and you give also some recommendations. So, escojamos la situación, choose the situation, all right? And then we are going to come and present it. So, vamos a quedarnos en grupos de 2, van a ser de 2, like 3 máximo, para que puedan practicar tanto como sea posible. So, explain the situation, lo mejor que puedan, you know, give details, den muchos detalles para que practiquemos vocabulario también, and then we come back. So, get going, guys. Let's go there. No escojan el más fácil, please. Escojan el que sea más retador. Choose the most challenging. Porque ya los veo escogiendo el número 5. I have a headache. So, please, no, not number 5. I have a headache. I know, yo sé que no. Pero por si acaso lo pensaron, not number 5. Okay, guys. So go there. Tienen 10 minutos. You have only 10 minutes to go and present it. And then I want to listen to everybody. Alrighty, thanks a lot for coming back. Okay, so I guess some of you are like coming super quick. And so how was your practice? Creo que I was listening to most of you and that was very interesting. Tiene muy buenas recomendaciones. I guess me gustó que se tomaran el tiempo para compartirse lo que habían entendido about the situation. So, cuál era en realidad la situación, qué es lo que estaba pasando, you know. So, thanks a lot for that. Now, vamos a crear una conversación cortita. That was the idea, to make a super short conversation and give recommendations, of course. So, the idea is to just talk about it, explicar qué es lo que está pasando, and then give a couple of recommendations. La número 5 está bien fácil, así que si escogieron una diferente al número 5, that would be awesome. Okay, because the other one is como, yeah, but it's very limited in cuestiones de vocabulario, okay? So, I don't know if I have any volunteer or I should go with some victims.
Hi.
Dennis.
Yes.
So, Dennis, you'll be the first. So, ¿quién es en su grupo? Who is in your group? Natalie and Marvin. Okay, Natalie and Marvin. What is the situation?
The situation.
You better tell us.
Okay.
Bye.
Yeah, you better start. That would be nice.
Bye. Go, Marvin.
Híjole, espérame. Hi, guys.
Hi, Marvin.
How are you? How are you?
I'm fine. And you?
I'm fine. I tell you, I with married and I had a have a son because I have a problem.
What is your problem?
My child wake up very often in the middle of the night. He sleep usually during the day. I haven't had any good sleep for weeks. What shall I do?
I tried it, Marvin. Oh, Natalie, I have the experience, and your son?
Yes, I have some experience about it. I have two sons. I think you should take and go to psychotherapeuta, or you should then let him to sleep.
Okay, I will do that activity.
Okay, in my experience, son, and we go to the psychotherapeuta. The psychotherapeuta recommended to do a schedule and it's great some activity, some weekly activity. And the son have to do all activities of at long day and at end of day, they will be exhausted.
I will try. Maybe it will work. Thanks, Natalie. Thanks, everybody.
You're welcome, Marvin.
Yeah, super nice. Amazing. I like your recommendations. Like, they sounded very natural and they sounded like very good recommendations. You put like a lot of vocabulary into practice. So, great job. That was very good. Congrats, guys. Anybody else who is ready to go next? Who wants to go next? I can take one more.
The next.
Yeah. So Marvin, give me one number, please, from 1 to 7.
Hagamos llegar ese saludo hasta la ciudad de Atequizaya.
Who is in Atequizaya?
La señorita Delgadillo.
Oh, really? Isn't it Ana Delmi? Jackie, are you ready? Is your group ready? Jackie, let me see who was. Oh, Ana Delmi, Ricardo, and Sandra were with Jackie. Guys, chicos, ¿están listos? Are you ready?
Yes, teacher, pero solo con Ricardo porque Sandra no la vimos.
Y creo que ya que no se pudo conectar. All right. Okay, no problem. That's okay. That's okay.
No sé si está listo Ricardo.
Yes.
Okay. Already.
Ready.
Let's go.
Okay. Hello, Ricardo. How are you today?
Hi, Ana Delmi. I have pressure. What do you what should I do?
Oh, really? You should take a pill.
Are you already take a book? Don't hear beat.
Oh, no. You should visit the doctor.
Yes, it is okay. Thank you for your recomposition, Ana Delmi.
Oh, you're welcome.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye bye.
Already, perfect. Thank you guys. That was all right. So very good job. And you gave like very interesting recommendations too. So unfortunately we couldn't listen to Jackie or Sandra, but that was very nice. Thanks a lot. Okay, we will continue practicing this later, but I'm super glad que los grupos practicaron enough, you know. So tengo solamente one last activity before we end up today's class. Así que let's move on a little bit. Y esta super cortita, it's super, super short. And this is about salutations and closings. Y con esto terminamos unit number 3. So it says formal and informal. Tenemos como two different sides of the story. Classify these salutations and closings into formal or informal. And here, for example, we have see you, hey, what's up, hello, Mr. and Mrs., dear friend, XOXO, thank, THNX, best regards, morning, and my best. So lo que quiero que me ayuden a hacer ahorita, before finishing, es solamente esto, identificar estas palabras, these words, en formal o informal, all right? So, comenzamos con formal salutations. ¿Cuáles de estos saludos se consideran formales? What do you think, guys?
Morning.
Morning.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, Mr. o Miss.
Okay, hello, Mr. and Miss.
Dear friend.
See you.
Yeah, dear friend.
Dear friend.
See you, teacher.
See you.
No.
Best regards.
Exactly.
Best regards.
Nuestro best regards es como atentamente, right? O saludos cordiales. So best regards. Okay.
Dear friend.
Dear friend, yes. Well, de hecho, dear friend. No, imagínense que es para business, para una empresa. So, a pesar que somos amigos con alguien, le escribirían como dear friend or hello mister or hello missus. What do you think?
No, yo le escribiría como dear friend porque dear como, friend. Bueno, normalmente un correo siempre tiene que ir formal, digamos.
Uh-huh.
O en alguna carta de trabajo siempre tiene que ser formal.
So, imagínense que le está escribiendo a alguien que es su amigo, pero para propósitos de negocio, you know, de un ambiente más formal. So, ¿utilizaría dear friend?
No.
No.
Probably no. Not, right?
Hello, no. Mister o Miss.
Mm-hmm. Aunque hello, sea mi amigo, right? Yeah, because yeah. Suena demasiado cercano, yes. Mucha confianza. Okay, okay.
Hay que guardar la distancia, teach.
Yes. Aunque sea el vecino y uno que vive a la par, los conozcan desde pequeños, normally we are talking about a professional environment, okay? So informal, entonces, ¿qué usamos para informal?
Hey.
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 What's up?
Exactly.
Hey, man.
Sos.
Wait, an email, Brenda.
Okay. Exclamó la princesa.
Upsi. Ups, tenía el micrófono abierto.
Se acabó la princesa.
Okay, so hey, what's up? Okay. Ahí sí podemos usar this dear friend because it's a friend.
Teacher. Yo nunca supe qué quiere decir esa palabra, sotso.
Ajá. Ok, es como, ok, it's actually XOXO, que es como besos y abrazos.
Besos y abrazos.
En serio.
Yeah. Super informal. X, creo, si no me equivoco, son los besos, they are kisses. Besos. And O, I think it's like hugs. Ajá. Pero es muy informal. This is like super informal. Es como escribirle, I don't know, LOL. O escribirle esto, por ejemplo, thanks.
Thanks.
La forma bien informal de thank you. Or hay más. There are more that we can use. For example, pueden usar esto. Y esto es un gracias. This is a thank you. O en vez de decir see you, puede escribir algo así. Y es see you, you know. But those are abbreviations that are very informal. So just FYI. Por si alguna vez ven un TY, ese es un thank you. Y si ven un C y la U, eso es un see you, de nos vemos, right? See you. Normally we use them in chats, WhatsApp, pero no correos formales, not like in professional emails.
Miss, esa cuestión.
Ingrid.
Pero ¿y por qué el toxo, o sea, lo asemejan a esas dos palabras? O sea, no entiendo la similitud.
Le debo la respuesta, because to be honest, I don't know. Pero se la averiguo, and if I get it, I'll let you know tomorrow. Y si alguien también la puede averiguar, you know, that would be nice. Because nunca he buscado el de dónde viene, you know, it's just, así se usa.
¿Por qué escribes?
De hecho, yo lo usaba, when I was a teenager, lo usaba, pero en español, you know, de hecho, no lo usaba en inglés, I used it in Spanish. So, to be honest, se lo voy a averiguar. Guys, antes de irnos, solo déjenme confirmar asistencia, me hacían falta algunos en el control inicial. So si me ayudan with your camera, that would be wonderful. Brian, Mr. Brian, ya está por acá. Celia, Jasmine, no había Jasmine today.
Present.
I was also missing René, but René is right there.
I am here.
Thank you, Brian. Ángel, Ángel didn't come today. Carlos Alberto, thank you very much, Carlos. Acabo de ver a Carlos.
I am.
Hey.
Thank you very much. No lo lograba ver. Ignacio, he didn't come. And Marvin. Ahí está.
Present.
Okay, amazing. Thank you. Guys, solamente un breve recordatorio. Necesitamos 80% de asistencia como mínimo. Hablamos de contabilizado los minutos de conexión y el 80% de asistencia. Agradecerle a quienes se conectan súper temprano, you know, y quienes llevan el 100% de attendance. Recordemos que INSAFOR mide minuto a minuto, all right? Así que si en algún momento tienen problemas de internet, eso nos afecta, pero compensamos con el hecho de estar el resto de las clases al 100%. Así que agradecerles por eso. Nos vemos el día de mañana. Tenemos tarea en la plataforma, please, que no se les acumule. Iniciamos la semana número 4. Si la pueden terminar antes, mejor, y ya se van sin el pendiente que tienen tarea. Moses, tenemos one-on-one. Si me regala unos minutitos, please. Los demás estamos dismissed. And I'll see you tomorrow. Have a good night.
Sí,
bye, tomorrow. Guys.
Sleep well.
Teacher, solo una pregunta.
Have a good night.
Dígame, Delmi.
Fíjese que yo no he entendido bien eso de la tarea, si lo vamos a hacer con un amigo.
Oh, no, lo que sucede es que si ya vio el video, es como una conversación, ¿verdad? Right?
Ajá, sí.
Entonces, ajá, podemos pedirle a alguien que nos ayude a leer la otra parte, si usted conoce a alguien. O, por ejemplo, usted trabaja con Jackie, me imagino que la ve todos los días. So solamente lo graban juntas, ¿verdad? Para que practiquen. So, es una recomendación, no es necesario que realmente lo haga con un amigo. O si lo hace usted sola, hace el cambio de tono de voz y eso es todo.
Ah, ok. Y si, pero las mismas preguntas son que salen ahí.
Es que vamos a hacer una práctica de pronunciación y fluidez. Entonces no le van a cambiar nada, solamente es intentar decir lo mismo que ellos dicen, con el mismo tono de voz, la misma velocidad y la misma pronunciación.
Ok, o sea, ya.
Es lo mismo.
Gracias,
teacher. Yo lo hice mal. Entonces yo le entendí mal, porque yo sí le mandé una nota de voz a usted, pero no así como está explicando ahorita.
¿Cómo le mandó? How did you send it?
Bueno, se lo mandé por WhatsApp a usted.
No me he caído. Bye. Si gusta, escríbame, porfa, porque probablemente se me perdió on the email, porque no recuerdo haber recibido. Like, you can send me a text.
Ok.
Nos vemos, chicos. Enjoy.
Bye, bye. Sí. Thank you, teacher.
Welcome. Ay, Moses, deme un segundito que me ya está seco. Déjenme solo limpiar aquí el queue. Ahí está. Ok, gracias, Moses, por su tiempo. Thanks a lot for that. No le voy a quitar mucho tiempo, solo unos 10 minutitos quizás. Por lo general, nuestra sesión de one-on-one es para revisar algún tema que tengamos pendiente, anything. Algún tema que sienta que necesita un poquito de clarification, más ejercicios, o si tiene como feedback, comments o algo, pues ahí lo podamos practicar. La verdad es que me alegra mucho que ya su internet esté súper bien, que ya se esté conectando like every day, porque, I mean, yeah, I was the first days, sí estaba como, ¿qué pasó? Y uno, Moses es bien responsable, so,
pero, but I'm happy. La primera semana. Yo pensé que iba a desistir, ¿verdad?, del módulo, porque se me estaba poniendo bien complicado, más allá del internet, del trabajo, porque casualmente me cambiaron un horario. A las 9, y de hecho, todos los días a las 9:30 de la noche, yo tengo que confirmar un personal que entra a una planta de producción. Entonces, me llaman por teléfono si hace falta, o tengo que mandar el correo de alguien para que ingrese. Y me están llamando las personas que están en la planta. Mira, viene fulano, mandé el correo que entre. O mira, no vino fulano, hay que buscar a alguien. Entonces, era mentira que iba a poder estar. Entonces, me tocaba salirme, abrir la compu, abrir otro archivo. Entonces, yo dije, no voy a poder, porque no voy a poner atención, no voy a aprender nada. Voy a ir al otro módulo y voy a ir nulo. Pues. Pero, gracias a Dios, las cosas ya fueron un poquito más tranqui. Y ya pude conectarme y enfocarme ya. Ha habido veces que sí, tal vez a las 9:30, como en dos ocasiones me tuve que desconectar a las 9:30 porque no podía, era mentira.
Ni sí, claro.
Saliendo. Entonces, pero ahora sí, ya estoy más ¿qué? Ya yo me rebusco, ya, para que sí puedan salir las cosas.
Ya se organizó mejor, so ajá. You are more like organized.
Y eso del internet, créanme que me ayudó un montón, porque la primera semana sí estaba puro...
dato.
Pero me mudé, entonces ahora estoy viviendo por el lado de como San Juan o Pico y la señal era mala y ahora ya con el internet pues ya, o sea, aunque no haya señal allá afuera, aquí tengo toda la señal.
Ay, qué bueno, so that sounds better. Bye. Los cambios siempre son si son para bien, ¿verdad? Qué bueno que sucedieron y me alegra que siga con nosotros y que siga trabajando por ello. Sí, yo lo veo que va mejorando bastante, va avanzando a lot, lo veo con mucho más vocabulario, y la verdad es que a mí me alegra mucho, you know, que sí vayan avance, ¿verdad? Y que también usted lo note.
Siempre manejo aquello que le dije, que siempre venía como escuchando.
Claro, viendo videos, recuerdo.
Ahora en la mañana igual venía de Chalate, y puse ahí un par de videos que ayudan bastante, como listening, ¿verdad? escuchar música. Y si diera mi carro, le diera risa, ando post-it pegados así.
Cool.
Cuando alguien se sube, me dice, hey, estás estudiando inglés, porque lo veo.
Vocabulario.
Ajá, de repente ver.
Tómele foto mañana y la comparte en el grupo. Ese es un muy, muy buen motivador, porque tal vez el resto de compañeros no lo han considerado, and that can work for them. Yo lo estoy en mi casa.
los que ya me puedo, o sea, lo que coloqué en el post-it, ya sea un verbo o algo, o sea, lo arranco y lo quito, ¿verdad? Y voy poniendo uno nuevo. Ahí está.
Nice. Póngalos, intente con los verbos, intente con presente pasado, you know, so uh-huh. You can watch them every day. But no, I like that. Uh-huh.
Y ayuda, aunque sea ir aprendiendo una palabrita ya a la semana. Tal vez no
lo que pasa es que usted los está viendo, lo que pasa es que como visualmente lo tiene ahí, nuestro cerebro se va acoplando, you know, and you see them. De alguna forma lo absorbemos. Wow, but that's a nice technique. Especialmente porque si tiene como lugares muy lejos, si tiene que viajar muy lejos o si pasa mucho tiempo en el carro, tiene más exposición a ellos. That sounds nice. Tómele foto, nos la muestra mañana. That would be a nice motivator, yeah. Y con los temas, ¿cómo se siente? Yo sé que ahorita ya se siente un poquito más como, tema nuevo, right? But how do you feel?
Creo que sí he agarrado como la idea. Creo que okay. Todo, y como usted dijo que este módulo era bien como repetitivo, constante y largo, o sea, la idea principal creo que sí la tengo y así se va reforzando en cada clase, cada cosita. Y de igual manera ahí repaso en el cuaderno cuando algo me cuesta o inclusive el traductor o algo creo que también ayuda para medio retomar la idea y así vamos.
Claro, it helps a lot. ¿Hay algún tema ahorita que no le haya quedado como muy claro, que le haya quedado con dudas o que no, you didn't get it? Hemos estado viendo la parte de would you mind para permiso, should para recomendación y los pasados, right?
Sí, no, hasta ahorita no creo que igual hemos, en las participaciones que hemos tenido, en todas las he tenido listas, ¿verdad? En mi caso me tocase e interpretarlas, en algunas lo he hecho y aparentemente está bien. Entonces creo que sí, la idea, como le digo, principal se ha agarrado, solo es de ir como practice.
Yeah, y es de tomar nota, right? So toma nota de vocabulario, you practice y luego lo revisa. So de eso se trata, porque si uno no practica igual a uno se le olvida. Uh-huh.
Así que
bye, pero ya, que me alegra entonces.
Ya me inscribí el módulo 4, ya está todo.
¡Ay, qué bueno! Sounds good. Porque de hecho terminamos el lunes, ya vamos a terminar. Y este módulo se ha ido bien rápido.
Aprovechen. Yo me recuerdo que en su momento dijeron, que, y me da como la curiosidad, de que dijeron que iban a entregarnos por cada módulo como un algo. Pero quizá lleva tiempo, ¿no?
Sí, lo que pasa es que lo hace directamente INSAFORM. Como hay dos requisitos para que ustedes puedan tener el módulo. Uno es la nota, ¿verdad? Del 80% de plataforma y el otro es asistencia. Y ya que la asistencia se mide en minutos, es como una auditoría así de segunditos de cuánto le hace falta y una para llegar al 80%. Entonces, puede que tome un par de meses. No es así como inmediatamente el siguiente día, ¿verdad? Por el momento no nos han dicho si ya están listos, pero déjeme preguntarle a los compañeros, tal vez ellos tengan ya algún dato específico o si usted puede dar una llamadita a su recurso humano porque les están llegando a recursos. INSAFORM sí da un diploma donde dice terminó módulo 1, módulo 2, etcétera.
Sí, ahí no creo que haya llegado a la oficina porque ya me hubieran dicho, pero... Igual me imagino que ha de estar en un proceso, como usted dice, es una cuestión de que lo revisan bien, bien minuciosamente.
Sí, es bien detallado.
De algo que no sea cierto.
No, de hecho sí, es una auditoría así, minuto a minuto, por eso nuestra intención, ¿verdad? Que ustedes se conecten tanto como sea posible. Pero sí, les va a llegar, yo no solo tenga un poquito de paciencia. Have a little patience there. Yeah, vale, pues Moisés, le agradezco por el tiempo. Thanks a lot for your time. Cualquier cosa, let me know, me puede escribir y ahí voy a estar pendiente, all right? Sí. Me alegra que siga con nosotros y que ya está para el cuarto módulo. So I'm super happy about it already. Vale, pues que descanse. Have a good night. Sí.